What is inflation? Inflation is an increase in the price level of goods and services over a period of time. In simple terms, it is that a dollar today buys less than it did previously. In most cases, it's expressed as a percentage rate. So, if inflation is 2%, a $3 box of milk will now cost $3.06. It may not seem to be much, but keep in mind that inflation is a reflection of price rises across the economy. People whose earnings do not grow in sync with the cost of living may be unable to maintain their current lifestyles due to excessive inflation. If the rate of inflation exceeds 50%, you've entered the hyperinflation zone. Expect costs to rise on nearly everything. Stagflation happens when inflation occurs during a recession. In turn, this can result in hyper unemployment and very low purchasing power. Inflation has a variety of causes, but the two most common are demand pull and cost push. Producers raise prices when consumer demand is high in order to maximize profits. This is known as demand pull. Whereas cost push, producers raise prices to cover rising costs. Inflation may have a major influence on your cost of living over time. It has an impact on everyone, from individuals to corporations and the stock market. As an investor, you may wish to seek the advice of a financial expert to assist you safeguard your interests and hedge against inflation. Inflation is a significant factor in the economy that affects everyone's finances. Here's an in-depth look at its five causes so you can know it better. Economic growth. Unemployment falls and wages generally rise in a booming or expanding economy. As a result, more individuals have more money in their pockets, which they are prepared to spend on both pleasures and needs. This increased demand allows suppliers to raise prices, which leads to more jobs, which leads to more money in circulation, and so on. In this setting, inflation is viewed as beneficial. The Federal Reserve does, in fact, favor inflation since it is a sign of a healthy economy. The Fed, on the other hand, wants only a small amount of inflation, aiming for a core inflation rate of 2% annually. Increase in the money supply. Demand pull inflation can also be fueled by a larger money supply. This occurs when the Fed creates money at a faster rate than the economy's growth rate. Demand rises as more money circulates, and prices rise in response. Government regulation. The government has the power to enact new regulations or tariffs that make it more expensive for businesses to produce or import goods. They pass on the additional costs to customers in the form of higher pricing. Cost push inflation develops as a result of this. Dealing with the national debt. When the national debt becomes overwhelming, the government has two options. One is to increase taxes in order to make debt payments. If company taxes are raised, companies would most likely pass the cost on to consumers in the form of increased pricing. This is a different type of cost push inflation situation. The government's second alternative is to print more money. Of course, as explained earlier, this can lead to demand pull inflation. As a result, if the government utilizes both ways to address the national debt, demand pull and cost push inflation may be affected. Exchange rate fluctuates. When the US dollar's value falls in respect to other currencies, it loses purchasing power. In other words, imported goods, which account for the vast majority of consumer goods purchased in the United States, become more expensive to purchase. Their price rises. The resulting inflation is known as cost push inflation. Inflation is related to price increases across the economy. Inflation can be caused by a lot of reasons, including government involvement. Even the government's attempts to control inflation can worsen. However, a little inflation is a positive thing, as it indicates that the economy is growing. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and leave us a thumbs up so we can make more investing videos for you in the future. And also, we will be very happy if you can also share it on social media. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Take care.